guys, welcome to part two of this probably three-part series here. And before we get started with this one, I just wanted to show you guys the actual schematic I'm using to make this circuit. And I figure it might be a pleasant little experience. I'm going to draw it out with a Sharpie on this page. Kind of Blue's Clues style to reference them a second time in two videos, because I always like that, so we'll get right to it. And then after this, we'll jump into actually building it again, or continuing building it. So, and I apologize, but it's gonna have to be upside down, which won't make a difference until I start labeling it. But I'll post a picture or something in the information section for anybody interested. So like every circuit, it has an input and an output. Or most circuits, I guess it can be an arbitrary term. But we'll start with our input side and kind of work our way over. So we got a capacitor. It goes to a resistor. And this resistor is going to connect to our first operational amplifier. And the output of this op-amp is going to be connected to the inverting input, which would be a negative sign. Space in there so that I can label it later. So the output going in a resistor there, just to regulate the current that's being spit back. It's called a feedback loop right there. And then another resistor between the second op amp and it. I'm sure you guys can hear my handwriting is a little bit shaky just because of that one too many cups of coffee right now. This time with a resistor in parallel with a 22 picofarad capacitor. And another resistor off the output. Second op amp, and this one's going to go all the way out there, and this will be, sorry, it looks like the word out, it's out, output, input, and alright, I'll just kind of leave it there. Okay. Sorry, I just kind of thought to do that. A little bit late, but better than never. Okay. All right. Yeah. Okay, so we got our feedback. Oh, by the way, this is actually the potentiometer. Arrow there signifies that you can vary the amount of resistance right there. And okay, we got all that done. And now the positive or non-inverting input of the op amp is going to go, I can make it a little more, I guess, all the way to the other. Designate that it does not touch the wire it jumped over. And we're going to go straight up. Okay. And up here we have a switch for the battery. Designate that it is, in fact, a battery that emits direct current if you hook a circuit up to it and not alternating current. And that box just means that's the negative. Or this will be the general purpose ground of the entire circuit. And it appears up here they want us to put a box designating the positive lead. Okay, let me go back down here now. And we can finish up this just writing a similar to this, but a three lines successively smaller than the first to let you know it's a ground, or an upside down triangle works too. Okay. And then we're going to make a capacitor jump from here. Those are kind of sloppy. All the way down here. And now this capacitor looks different than this capacitor. Because they're... I always get the two mixed up. I'm guessing these are the electrolytic ones. The larger values are the cylindrical looking capacitors, like... Where they at? Like this one. So I think if I'm right, that one's that one, and then the other one is like smaller ceramic looking ones like that, or like that. neutral lit capacitor right here. Resistor jumps up. Okay, we got that done. And then, yeah, that's done. And then, yeah, we just need to show the diodes. Use my fancy French made Bic 4 color pen, although it's missing red. We can get by with using blue. Excuse me. Alright. You know what? Yeah, I guess I can do that. One of these has the value C1. I'll label my capacitors in blue. Nice happy little blue. And my resistors, I think I'll label those in green. Oh shoot. That's microfarad. Microfarad, C4 down here, it's going to be 100 microfarad, that's what it is. These are labeled differently than these capacitors because these are polarized, so it makes a difference which way you put these ones. Yeah, that's right, and it makes sense now because they have a little negative symbol right there. To let you know that this smaller lead is negative. These guys aren't. They are impervious to polarization. C4. It's going to be, like I said, 100 microfarads. And then C5 is 10 microfarads. Pico being 10 to the negative 12th times whatever number. Micro being 10 to the negative 6th power. And then our last one is 0.22 microfarads. This guy right here. That would be C3. Still got some. Yeah, still got some green juice. R1 is going to be 47K. And that's 47,000 ohms. And R2 is going to be 10K. battery is another 10 kilo ohms. And then R4 is not 47 but 4.7 kilo ohms. This is a variable resistor. Yeah, I know there's a difference between variable resistors and potentiometers, but I unfortunately always forget. But this one is going to be, well, it's supposed to be rated at 500 kilo ohms, but I didn't actually measure it, which I should do. Actually, I'll get my handy dandy multimeter and take a look at it. And this is going to be our 9 volt battery. I don't know why I labeled that green. I just screwed my whole color coordination up. What else we got? R5, okay. That little bugger's at 33 kilo ohms. And R6, another 10 kilo ohms. And my diodes. I think that's it for my resistors. Don't have a red on this one. Well, I sure got one on this one. I love these pens. Maybe I'll make this one. Volts DC. Alright, red's gonna be for these diodes and any other thing here. These are going to be 1N914/4148, I believe. There's the pack. 1N4148/1N4148. And then I'm just going to label these. This would be pin 6. This would be pin 2, pin 3, so pin 6, pin 2, and pin 3. These are my 7-4. Or 741s. Jeez. Little simple op amp chips. Oh, I forgot to draw my positive and negative rails coming off these. Positive is 7, negative is 4. That's pin 7 and pin 4 on the little op amp chip. Pin 1 being that guy. Oh, this is also, let's see, battery. Basically, we have our input, which gets intercepted by these two components, the resistor and capacitor, allowing the current level to be controlled and kind of smoothed out before it enters the op amp. So you want it to receive, you want this op amp to receive the desired signal, and that's how, that's where these come into play. Or the desired level of current, and as it goes into the negative, what that means is that it will actually reverse whatever waveform that will enter here. It'll spit out the negative of it. So if it's positive, 10 milliamps, it'll be negative 10 milliamps. You could sort of think of it like that. Oh wait, no, that's not right. It'll shift the frequency of it, or the angle of it. Never mind. Okay, I screwed that one up pretty bad. But yeah, anyways, it does it uses this input, performs an amplification of it, and then it spits out an output which will go to this. But a little bit of the output will also feed back into this. And as this will actually be the physical switch, you see right here, which can have, anyways, it looks like that. These three nodes right here connect to the circuit. And so once I have this in the actual circuit built, I'll actually be able to adjust this. I'll be able to adjust the amount of current exiting this op amp that goes into here, and that'll actually, in a way, it'll be adjusting the distortion, but also the volume that is output from the actual circuit. And this second op amp, I think it again might be sort of a regulator. I'm not 100% though, honestly. And then the rest of this is just power. So this op amp here is going to, once this switch is closed, that switch closes like that, and it'll receive positive power right there, and as well as here. And then these capacitors are just for just to make the circuit work, really. Okay, so obviously I'm not too schooled on this. It's been a while since I've looked at something with op amps in it, but that's the gist of it. And yeah, so let's get to finishing this up. Okay, we're back. This is going to be episode 2, and hopefully we finish it. So we got a couple components installed here, and with any luck, we'll fill up the rest of this board within this next hour here. And with any more luck, you guys will be fast asleep by the time I get it done. And I think I'll post another video most likely not ASMR, that once I get it working, granted that I do, I'll show you how it works. So, let's begin. So what we need is 2 10-kilo-ohm resistors. And we're going to put those in series, which means one end, the end of one touches the end of another, you know, something like that. But gosh, this, I mean, the schematic, I should just look at the schematic, but I'm trying to follow these pictures, and, it's proving pretty interesting to figure out. Because as you see, the top side of the board doesn't divulge any secrets as to the connections of the bottom. So, you gotta be aware of that the whole time. And I'm not, like I said before, I don't want to make mistakes. Okay. Okay, so it doesn't look like we're putting these, we're gonna make these connect to the first capacitor I just installed. And C1 is right there. C1's gonna be on the input. Okay, so we got C1, R1 connected to the non-inverting, or the inverting of the first op amp. And then R1 and R2 and R3 are going to be connected to the positive terminal of the battery, and then grounded. Okay. Okay. You're gonna hear me say that a lot. Just getting my bearings. Where are we gonna put this? And these guys we'll go ahead and put on their own little nodes. I guess we'll put them right here. Nope, that's not what we want. Well, if I do screw this up, it'll be a good tutorial in how not to build a fuzz box, at least. But if I don't, and I think I will, I'll be that much more pleased. Okay, and then we're gonna put the next one right here. Alright. I'm gonna pop it right through, bend it down to hold it in place while I solder. And up, snip them off, alright, so now we got these by themselves, and what are we going to do? We're going to connect to the central, to the connecting node right between these two, where they're connected right here. We're going to put a jumper, a wire. We're going to connect the junction of these, R2 and R3, to the non-inverting, or the positive input of the op-amp. Okay. Which also just so happens to be the I knew I had a lot more wires at some point. Okay, I'm gonna have to cut my own jumpers here, my own leads. You're gonna strip the wire like that. And it's just a short jump, so we'll make a fairly short wire. Go ahead. We're gonna be really professional and use our teeth. Okay. So that right. I should have thought about that. This is funny. Okay, so we got our jumper. He's jumping around. Not inverting to the central of that. Okay. Okay. Alright, using a short piece of wire, connect pin 3 to pin 5 of IC1. And pin 5. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so that's the positive. So that was the. That was the non-inverting input of the first op amp. And now we need to connect that input into the non-inverting input of the second. Make sure I got that right. Yeah, man, that's right. Alright, groovy. Very cool. By the way, I don't know if you guys have heard of this award-winning beer. Apparently only the finest hops and grains are used. It was selected as America's best beer in really recently, in 1893, actually. And what other accolades does it have? I guess they're not flouting too much now, but apparently it won a blue ribbon. So I don't know, I've been trying it lately, and it's not too bad. It's a great price too. I feel like it's kind of obscure, maybe you guys haven't heard of it, but yeah, check it out if you can. And actually, I genuinely think, I really wonder if it's exported. It's American beer, but I'm curious if anybody over in Europe or anything, or Asia has heard of Pabst Blue Ribbon. PBR, as it's colloquially phrased as. That was another in a long series of my bad jokes, by the way. Just trying to keep it light. I like that beer. Okay. So we're gonna connect pin 3 to pin 3. So you guys see here, pins counterclockwise. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So we're gonna stick this in pin 3, run it to the other pin 3. Actually, I need to make this lead a little bit shorter. Okay. Still shorter. I'm gonna slip that into pin 3. Slip this guy right into the other pin 3. And usually I do like to have my wires really flush, but again, I'm not too concerned with the aesthetics of this thing. I just want it to work. Which hopefully that plan doesn't backfire, because usually when you worry about aesthetics, you do tend to pay attention more closely to what you're doing. But hopefully I'm paying just enough attention to make it work, and everybody will be happy. And by everybody, I mean me and my guitar. Okay. Again, we're gonna snip. And now we got something resembling a circuit. We're about, I'd say, a third of the way there. As far as what to mount on the board and to make the whole project, we're probably about a quarter of the way there. So once I do that, I'm gonna connect a short piece of hookup wire on the underside of the board from the bottom of the point of R3. This will be the ground point of the circuit. R3 and of R2 with a short piece of wire. To pin 8 of IC1. The circuit. End of R2, end of R3. Okay. So we're going to make another stretch of wire. And should be about that long. And we're gonna do a little bit of this. Connect this to ground. Okay. And we're going to call ground this conduction layer. All around here. Oh no, sorry. Wow, that should have been ground, huh? That's okay, yeah, we want that anyway. So that actually will be ground. We'll call that ground. Snip. So now we got the ground wire, and we're gonna take the other end of this. connected to the DC voltage on that pin, the VCC plus, which will be pin 7 for us. Yeah, I have a feeling in about 20 minutes this is going to get really, this is going to diverge quite a bit from the schematic I'm looking at based on one IC when I'm using two ICs. It's funny how simple, it's like chaos theory over there, a little butterfly effect. It started off being a simple little difference, and it's probably gonna radically change by the end of this. But, no, we'll work with it. We'll figure it out. I feel like this might be a mix between, like, what's his name? I saw one ASMR chick, that one girl, doing a parody of the guy who paints and talks really softly, Bob. Oh, what's his name? You guys are gonna be like yelling at the monitor when I say, "What's his name?" Bob Ross. That's right, Bob Ross. Thanks for helping me out there. Yeah, I feel like it's a mix between Bob Ross and Blues Clues here. Oh, Bob Ross, that guy's amazing. I feel like he was the proto ASMR figure, you know? Like, if YouTube would have been around, he would have had a million views per video within like a week. Oh, Bob Ross. So we're gonna, the V positive is that, and we're gonna connect. We're gonna put a happy little, jumper right from ground to the positive DC biased rail on this IC here, this little cheerful IC chip here. Yep. And you guys just do whatever you want. It's your circuit board. You make it however you feel like making it. There's no right way to make a circuit board unless you unless you don't adhere to the schematic. Gee whiz. Okay, so I got that there. I got that there. I think I'm right. Nope, I'm not. Measure twice. Let's measure twice, everybody. Don't forget to measure twice. And everything work out all right, okay? Okay. So we're connecting our lead. Of that resistor to that. And we're gonna solder that baby up now. IC1, Sharpie's wire, IC1, supplier and drive is shown in the schematic by the plus in a box, symbol at 8 pin. This is not the same as the plus symbol at pin 3. Yeah, gotcha. I gotcha, buddy. I gotcha. Sorry, that's me talking to myself when I get, when I'm really trying to hash things out, make sure I got it right. And see, look at that. I almost did it. I think I got it right, but I think I need to measure three times. Just to make sure. Make sure I got that right, because I don't want to do it twice. Yeah, because that's the V out. That's going to be pin 7 for me. Yep. Very groovy. And I actually read somewhere that Bob Ross was an ex-military guy. And he got so sick of the prim and proper and unsympathetic lifestyle, I guess, that the military is, that he was just drawn towards the calmer side of things. And that's how he got into painting and hosting his own show. I guess he started by giving painting courses and really disliked yelling and loud, obnoxious voices. So, to me, that does seem like a quite natural progression. I'm sure if I ever get in the military, I'd leave with the same disposition as he apparently did. So that's going to, okay, so we hook up wire, connect pin 4 of the IC, and pin 4 is the negative, and it just so happens to also be the negative rail of my IC, to the common ground, the point you made previously. Okay, very groovy. Yeah, at the pace we're going now, guys, it might end up being a 3, maybe even 4-part series here. So, obviously, that's what YouTube's all about, huh? Watching at your discretion. If these aren't to your liking, I hope they will be, though. I hope they'll be kind of cool, because I personally like to sit and just kind of, you know, voyeur over someone's shoulder as they're building a circuit. Although, yeah, this one might be painfully slow for some and a little bit foreign to others. I'm not really sure what type of audience this might bring in, but I just do stuff that I would personally like. So that's where this is coming from. So pin 4, still going to be that little guy. Ooh, sorry guys. Pin 4. Yeah, and, I'm sure I'm going to be getting, I mean, if I ever make it to the point where, you know, thousands of people are watching these videos, I guarantee I'm going to get some backwash from professional or even student engineers who are looking at me like, what the hell are you doing? With all these same colored wires, you're supposed to have different colored wires to, designate positive, negatives, neutrals, grounds, and just to generally make it easier to look at and understand what's going on in the circuit. But I'm unfortunately restricted to just one color wire right now, so that's why I'm using all red. And we're gonna rock that all the way to ground. My ground rail is going to be the top here. Okay. I'll just put that there. Alright. Okay. Do that, and then do a little bit of this. Sorry, I should be showing my low def camera viewers what I'm doing here. Okay. So you see, basically, I've been working on this first op amp, operational amplifier. This is the second one, and we'll get to that in a minute. I'm pretty much used all my pins on the left side. The right side, I still have my output pin, which is pin 6 here, which is the second from the bottom. But yeah, you see, slowly making this an operational circuit. Snip snip. And I think we're just about done with this first IC. We'll be moving on to IC2. After a short break for me and instant for you.